Hello dear students, welcome to online platform of Divine Public School. I am here with lecture number 2. In lecture 1, we had discussed about definitions and properties of rational number. In this lecture, we will discuss remaining question of exercise 1.1. Okay, so let's start. Question number 3 is given, minus of minus x is equal to x for x is equal to 11 upon 15. Okay, so here we have x is equal to 11 upon 15. Therefore, minus of minus x is equal to minus 11 upon 15. Okay, we have x is equal to 11 upon 15. Therefore, minus of minus x is equal to minus 11 upon 15. Understand? And then in next step, minus of minus x will be equal to minus of minus 11 upon 15. Okay, so and you know, minus into minus will be equal to plus. So therefore, minus of minus 11 upon 15 will be equal to 11 upon 15. And you know, 11 upon 15 is equal to x. Therefore, this is equal to x. Understand? So it is verified that minus of minus x is equal to x. Understand? Similarly, you can do question number 3. Okay, so next question is given. Find the multiplicative inverse of the following. So multiplicative inverse, you know what is multiplicative inverse? Multiplicative inverse of A is equal to 1 upon A. Multiplicative inverse of X upon Y is equal to Y upon X. You know, multiplicative inverse means reciprocal. Okay, so reciprocal of minus 13 is equal to minus 1 upon 13. Reciprocal of 1 upon 5 is equal to 5, or 5 upon 1 is equal to 5. Understand? Similarly, reciprocal of this number. Okay, for this, first you multiply this both number, then you'll find the reciprocal of results. Okay, so first you find product of this, that means 5 minus 5 into minus 3 upon 8 into 7. Okay, so minus 5 into minus 3 is equal to minus 15, and 8 upon 7 is equal to 8 into 7 is equal to 56. Okay, so minus 15 upon 56. Understand? So reciprocal of minus 15 upon 56 is equal to 56 of minus 56 upon 15. Understand? Clear? So you can do remaining parts of the questions. Next question is asked, name the property under the multiplication used in each of the following. So it is asked, name the property used under multiplication. So here, in the form of 1 into A is equal to A into 1 is equal to A. Here, 1 is multiplied to minus 4 upon 5, and result is same. That means it is multiplicative identity. Okay? Second part is in the form of A into B. Second part here, A into B is equal to B into A. In the form of this, so this is commutative law. Understand? So it is asked to write only properties. Okay, so you can write properties. Which properties applicable used in this three question? So we can do now. Next question is given. Multiply 6 upon 13 to reciprocal of minus 7 upon 6. Minus 7 upon 6 it is given. So reciprocal of minus 7 upon 6 is reciprocal of minus 7 upon 6 is equal to minus 6 upon 7. Understand? Reciprocal of minus 7 upon 6 is equal to minus 6 upon 7. So it is given, multiply 6 upon 13 to reciprocal of this. Understand? So multiply this number 6 upon 13. Multiply 6 upon 13 to reciprocal of this number. So reciprocal of this number is minus 6 upon 7. So this will be equal to 6 6 is 36. So minus 36 upon 7 into 13. 91. Understand? Understand? Okay. Question is asked, multiply 6 upon 3 to reciprocal of this number. So first you find reciprocal of this number, minus 7 upon 6. Then multiply that number to 6 upon 13. So therefore this will be minus 36 upon 91. Okay, done. Now next question. So next question is given. So here this is done. Now it is given, tell what property allows to complete this. What property is applicable here? So here it is in the form of A into B into C, and here is equal to A into B into C. Understand? This is in the form of that. So this is associative property. Understand? So it is asked, tell the properties. Okay? So that means it is asked only properties. Okay? So which property? Associative property. Next question is given, is the multiplicative inverse of is 8 upon 9 is multiplicative inverse of minus 1 whole 1 upon 8. So you know how to check multiplicative inverse. So to check multiplicative inverse, remember one result. That result is product of a number with its multiplicative inverse is equal to 1. That means product of a number to its multiplicative inverse should be equal to 1. Understand? So here try to multiply both number. If product is 1, then this is multiplicative inverse, and if not, then it is not multiplicative inverse. So let's begin. So now you can write minus 1 whole 1 upon 8 is equal to 9 upon 8. You can write minus 1 whole 1 upon 8 is equal to 8 1 1 plus 1 9. So 8 1 8 plus 1 9, that means minus 9 upon 8. You can write. Done. So here this is minus 9 upon 8, and now multiply this number to this number. Okay, so now multiply this to minus 9 upon 8 into 8 upon 9. So 9 cancel and 8 cancel. So it will be equal to minus 1. This is not equal to 1. Okay, this is not equal to 1. So understand, product of this is equal to minus 1. Therefore this is not equal to 1. So this is not equal to 1. Therefore 8 upon 9 is not the multiplicative inverse of minus 1 whole 1 upon 8. Okay, then next question is given is 0.3 is multiplicative inverse of 3 whole 1 upon 3. Similarly, that question, this is similar to that question. Okay, in that question it is same thing. So here how to check? Multiply both number. If product is 1, then it is multiplicative inverse. If not, then not. Okay, so first try to convert in rational number. So you know 0.3 is equal to 3 upon 10, and 3 whole 1 upon 3 is equal to 3 are 9 plus 1, that means 10 upon 3. Now product of both number. So 3 upon 10 into 10 upon 3. So product is 3 cancel, 10 cancel is equal to 1. Okay, product of both number is equal to 1. So first try to convert both number in rational number. So 0.3 can be written as 3 upon 10, and 3 whole 1 by 3 is equal to 10 upon 3. Multiply 3 by 10 to 10 by 3, this is equal to 1. That means this is multiplicative inverse of, that means 0.3 is multiplicative inverse of 3 whole 1 by 3. Understand? Yes, so next question is, write the rational number that does not have a reciprocal. Okay, so write the rational number that does not have a reciprocal number. So 0 does not have a reciprocal. Why? 0 does not have a reciprocal. Why? Because 1 upon 0 is not defined. Understand? That's why 0 does not have a reciprocal. Second part is asked, the rational number that are equal to their reciprocals. Which rational number are equal to their reciprocals? Okay, so 1 is equal to their reciprocal. Why? Because reciprocal of 1 is 1 upon 1, means 1. And reciprocal of minus 1 is also equal to minus 1. So that's why 1 and minus 1 are equal to their reciprocals. Okay, now third part is given, the rational number that are equal to its negative. The rational number that are equal to its negative, which rational number are equal to its negative? So 0 is equal to its negative. Understand? So now this exercise 1.1 is finished. So next lecture number 3, we'll learn how to represent rational number on number line and how to find rational number between number lines, between two given rational number. Okay, thank you.